Your Honor, I'm Maxwell Graves for the state. This is Honorable Al Sharkskin for the defense on both of these cases today, sir.
And I'm Al Sharkskin from the street.
From the street, all right.
Yeah, straight from the street, Your Honor.
Straight from the street, well, Your Honor. I'm Honorable Judge Grimy Ricks. You know, I'm kind of new to the city. This is my first case of sitting in on some night court here.
Oh, lucky you, Your Honor.
Oh, yeah.
We did have a discussion before you came into the courtroom, Your Honor, about the hat that Mr. Sharkskin has on. I'll let him explain to you the reason for wearing a hat in the courtroom. I'm sure Your Honor would be okay with him keeping it on.
Oh, yeah, Your Honor. Again, I do. Let me stand. I do apologize, Your Greatness. I did have an unfortunate accident with some bacon grease a couple yesterdays ago, and I do got a real slightly scab right on the top of my head that may make you vomit if you was to look directly at. So if Your Honor, please, I keep my hat on this evening.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That pleases the court. That pleases the court very well.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Yeah, yes, sir. All right, gentlemen, I've got 0801 on my watch. Is all of our defendants here?
I know,
Yeah, I believe my defendants is both here, seated right behind me here. Do not mistake this lady for Wendy, from Wendy's restaurant. That is my client.
Okay.
Wendy from Wendy's restaurant is your client, or the lady sitting there in the
Oh, this lady room? Here. Okay. Yeah. You know, she only got her one ponytail, where Wendy would have two.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah, I can see the difference now. Okay. Thank you, sir.
All right, well, we can go ahead and get started with the first case on the docket. It's going to be our traffic case. Am I correct there, prosecution?
Yes, sir. It's going to be State of San Andreas versus Sherry Knorr.
All right.
Ms. Knorr, if you want to come on up here and have a seat right over there in the far seat over here at the table. Yeah, that second one over there. Yeah, there you go. Thank you, ma'am.
All right, are you ready for the state to proceed, Your Honor?
We are. We have Ms. Knorr in the courtroom. Prosecution, you may begin. I've already reviewed the written evidence at this time.
All right, thank you, Your Honor. My understanding is Sergeant Abood Malone, Unit Number 243 with the San Andreas County Sheriff's Department, is unavailable, but has submitted his traffic citation as his sworn affidavit to the occurrence that happened on that date. From the evidence on this case, Your Honor, the if it would please the court, I would enter in the traffic citation as the sworn statement of Sergeant Malone.
Yes, we'll enter that.
You have that narrative in front of you, Your Honor?
Yes, sir, I do. I've actually reviewed that and printed it out.
Okay. Mr. Sharkskin, you have any problem stipulating to that being the officer's testimony, sir?
Oh, no, sir. I have nothing to say about the evidence. We accept all evidence that's been submitted to the court.
Okay. That's all the state has for evidence, Your Honor, in this case. So with the submission of that into the court record, the state would rest and allow the defense to present their defense.
Okay. Floor is yours there, Mr. Sharkskin.
Thank you, Your Honor. I do appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
On the evening of this offense, Your Honor, my client, Ms. Knorr, was traveling in her vehicle and happened to be accompanied by her very esteemed licensed emotional cat. And being what cats are, an uncontrollable cat jumped up in her lap, Your Honor. And during her trying to retrieve that from her lap, she was, well, you say she hit the wheel, the cat hit the wheel and caused her to just do a little bit of a hit and run on that little car. Well, not a hit and run. She hit that car, Your Honor.
Okay.
She's amended to all charges, but would like you to take into account that she did have a cat. try to control as much as possible, but a horn blew rather scarily beside her vehicle, and that cat kind of got spooked, if you will.
Right, okay.
I did talk to the prosecutor. We kind of tried to work out something, and I'll let him explain that more when he comes back up. But that's basically the story, Your Honor. This isn't nothing, you know, big here. I don't have no big elaborate explanation.
All right.
Thank you, Mr. Sharkskin. Okay, Your Honor, so as Mr. Sharkskin stated, we had spoken prior to court about this case. Seeing as how Sergeant Maline is not here to give any further testimony besides his citation, the state would be fine with leaving this in the hands of the court to decide if we want to reduce this down to a lesser offense, maybe such as a speeding citation. My understanding is Ms. Nora did have valid automobile insurance in place, which is going to cover any of the damage. She was driving a semi truck at the time, and the vehicle that she struck during this process was a parked unoccupied vehicle, so there were no injuries to any citizens.
Okay.
The fine amount, suggested fine amount on a reckless driving charge, is $750 and a 10-day jail sentence. I would recommend reducing this down to some type of an infraction as opposed to a jailable offense.
The only thing that concerns me was the fact that, you know, it was a semi truck, so it had a potential to cause some serious injury. I'm willing to work it down as long as she promises the court that, you know, she can maintain her feline companion in the proper place while she is driving a vehicle.
She would be willing to approach the court and give her side of the story if that would help. Your Honor,
she's free to give her side of the story. I'm not restricting her ability to tell her side of the story.
All right, Your Honor, let me go ahead and call Sherry Noel to the witness stand so she could tell her story, this lovely story.
Okay.
About that emotional support cat. Make me teary-eyed just thinking about it.
Hello, Your Honor. Good evening.
Good evening, Miss Noel. How are you doing this evening?
Oh, I've been better. I'm a little nervous.
That's understandable.
So I'd like to assure you that this incident or anything like it will never happen again. I got him a proper harness to keep him harnessed in his seat at all times. There will be no more bouncing around the cab when anything noisy goes off again, or fly or horn, anything. I do apologize for the accident that happened, and I am willing to pay restitution if the owner of said vehicle wants that taken care of. I mean, I'm willing to do anything to make this, you know, correct.
Okay. You said you had insurance on your vehicle, so your insurance will pay for some of the damages.
Your Honor, could I speak to her?
Yes, sir, Mr. Sharkskin.
In her defense, the local whose car she's hit has not contacted her insurance company. We did leave a card. Okay. She has not contacted the court or myself that I know of. Okay. So there's a possibility that may have been no damages at all that we know of right now. So I want you, like you to take that into consideration, that there may have been no damages.
All right. Okay, well, I'll take that consideration, and I'll even put a time limit on it. You know, if we don't hear anything from the other vehicle's owner in 30 days, you know, we won't worry about any kind of restitution. If the person who owns the vehicle contacts your insurance company, you know, your insurance company pays out, and if there's anything left over, you know, restitution will be the equivalent to the leftover on vehicle repairs and any other repairs that might be in the neighborhood. Let's see. Prosecution, do you have recommendation for a lower charge?
Yes, sir. So, as opposed to reckless driving, there is an infraction that's fairly similar in nature. It's going to be PC 9007, negligent driving, which is an infraction only. It carries, of course, a 0 months jail term and a $300 fine.
Yes, sir. That's kind of where I was looking at myself, negligent driving. Mr. Shortskin, will you be all right with negligent driving for your clients?
Yeah, as long as there's no jail time, I think we'll be okay. Ms. Noel, did you need to get with me in a meeting about that, or are you willing to accept that?
I'm willing to accept that.
All right. Okay. You can come back on over here and sit down, Ms. Noel. Your Honor, for my client, we accept that agreement, sir.
All right. Well, considering she has no previous citations, we will agree with negligent driving. No jail time to be served with a fine of $300. 30 days time limit on any insurance claims against her insurance from the other driver. And if insurance claims are made, she must also pay the difference in restitution to the other driver that insurance does not cover. All right. And case closed.
Thank you, Your Grace. That was a beautiful steel cat, though, by the way. That brought a tear to my eye. You free to step back to the gallery, Miss Noor.
Okay, thank
you. I appreciate that beautiful story.
Call our next case.
All right, Your Honor, the next case is going to be the State of San Andreas versus Max Pickle.
Max Pickle, you may come up from the gallery, Mr. Pickle, and have a seat there in that far seat.
All right, gentlemen, for our execution?
Yes, sir. So, in this incident, sir, Deputy Russell Johnson is going to be the primary officer with the San Andreas County Sheriff's Department. He is here today and prepared to testify if necessary. This occurred at Postal 590 at the pawn shop. It was originally a report of shots fired at the pawn shop. And Deputy Johnson will be prepared to testify as to what he saw. There, basically, the allegations are that Mr. Pickle was holding two individuals at gunpoint inside the pawn shop there. One individual was Miss Sherry Noor, who unrelatedly was in our last case, and I believe it was her brother Tanner Noor. Both of those were in the pawn shop. And were held hostage. There is physical evidence that was obtained at the scene, that does come back to, Mr. Pickle and the weapons that were recovered from him. We also, there was fingerprint evidence recovered there. A hunting knife, was recovered, a Walther P99 pistol, and that evidence was logged in at the Mission Road Police Department by Deputy Russell Johnson with the Sheriff's Department. Your Honor, there was also in this case an evaluation that was done at the request of Mr. Sharkskin. Dr. Patel did a mental evaluation of the defendant. I believe you have a copy of that as well,
yes,
Your Honor.
Yes, I do. Very detailed, 3 or 4 pages long, very detailed mental evaluation.
Right. the state is willing to stipulate to that being the testimony of Dr. Patel if he were to be called, and would not challenge that letter or that finding by Dr. Patel in any way. If that's okay with Mr. Sharkskin, we could just put that into evidence as a testimony of Dr. Patel.
Mr. Sharkskin?
I have no objection to that being admitted.
Okay.
Yep. So basically the charges that that the state would prove in this case would be attempted murder of a civilian, two counts of attempted murder of a peace officer for the officers that were on scene, two counts of hostage taking, two counts of discharge of a firearm, and criminal possession of a weapon class A. All total, Your Honor, it would hold 242 months prison time and $32,800 in fines.
Hey, that map sounds right.
Yep. But I think we probably do need to get an official plea from the defendant. Mr. Sharkskin had reached out to me and requested that we consider reducing the postponing the prison time and possibly reducing it, but in turn requiring some inpatient stay in a mental health treatment facility.
Okay. I am willing to hear a plea enter at this time.
Your Honor, at this time we are going to plead guilty to the charges, as long as you consider our plea deal.
Okay.
What we are asking for here, Your Honor, is some sort of a mental evaluation, no matter how long it takes, whether it be one day or 10 years, and then go from there on whether you think that he needs to be sentenced to actual prison time. We are not pleading insanity, sir. This is a case of the spare and scary stuff, mental health, and my client is suffering tremendously under a lot of pressure. And I led him to do some scary, unthinkable things at the bank the other evening.
Yeah, right. Okay, yeah, I read over the assessment from Dr. Patel. He did include in there he was at one time attempting to seek some psychiatric help with a bipolar disorder. He was taking medications and such, but he also says the medications, he didn't like the way the medications felt sometimes. The only way I would consider a plea deal is if he did go to a mental health facility and spent some time in there. Willing to go that route. I will suspend all firearm rights for him definitely because there were other civilians in the area. I've actually drove out to that pawn shop location. That is a very populated street in that area, and bullets could have very easily hurt and or killed, maimed other civilians. So I will throw in a stipulation that his firearm rights will be suspended indefinitely due to the actions he took at that location.
Your Honor, that sounds good to me. You know, what we would like to see out of this, Your Honor, we know there's going to be some sort of punishment for this. You know, he's taken accountability for all his action. And he and I cried over dinner the other night. It was sad, Your Honor. I feel for this man. He's not saying he don't want to go to jail. You know, he mm-hmm. knows he's going to have to do something. But we'd like him to get with his doctor, Mr. Patel, and have him do regular visits and keep the court updated and myself and the prosecutor here. And then perhaps when we feel like he's mentally stable, then we can work on possibly a sentence that he would have to serve after that. But right now, he's a damaged man. He needs his brain fixed, Your Honor.
Yeah, I understand that. You know, I'm real big on mental health myself, so I am okay with some mental health help.
Are you mentally ill, Your Honor?
No, I'm a big proponent for mental health there, Mr. Okay. Sharkskin. I'm not mentally ill. I might be a little crazy for taking this job in this city, but I'm not mentally ill. But by the way, what did you eat there, Mr. Sharkskin? What did you and Mr. Pickle eat?
Well, we had some pickled hog feet and some collard greens and some cherry Kool-Aid over at my house. He cried and cried, and I was like, you have to hush your mouth about that. He's desperate, Your Honor, for help. Okay. Desperate.
Your Honor, the state would have no objection to entertaining that type of a plea deal, but I would like to get some testimony on the record, just in case once this is brought back up for review after his mental health treatment, that testimony is already part of the court record, so it could be included in the sentencing deliberation without having to recall the witnesses to that review hearing, Your Honor.
Mr. Sharkskin, you okay with no objections with that?
I don't have any objections with that, Your Honor. The truth needs to come out, needs to be heard.
All right. Well, Mr. Prosecutor, go ahead and call your witnesses for informational purposes.
All right. The state would call Deputy Russell Johnson, Unit Number 208 with the San Andreas County Sheriff's Department. Good evening, sir. Could you state your name, rank, and unit number for the record, sir?
Yes, sir. Deputy Russell Johnson, badge number 208 with the San Andreas County Sheriff's Office.
Thank you so much, Deputy Johnson. Deputy Johnson, you had an incident report that you put in where you had placed a Max Pickle under arrest for the charges that were read earlier. Did those charges fit with what you remember entering for your report, sir?
100%.
Okay. Do you see the subject, Max Pickle, that you referenced in your report? Do you see him in the courtroom today?
Yes, I do.
Could you point him out for us, sir?
Yes, sir. Right there. The guy standing next to the African-American lawyer.
Okay. I thank you so much. Your Honor, let the record show that the witness has identified the defendant, Max Pickle, there at the defense table.
All right. Record show it.
Deputy Johnson, can you give me a quick synopsis of what happened during that incident call when you arrived on scene?
Yeah, I definitely can. So I initially arrived at the scene and shortly followed up by a colleague, 109 and 105, I believe, which was a sergeant and another officer. We took up positions outside of the premises. We entered, myself and 105 entered the building and shouted, "We are law enforcement." We announced ourselves as law enforcement. Mr. Pickle arose from behind the case where he was stationed. He was stationed behind one of those display cabinets at the back of the store. He stood up, pointed a firearm, and discharged about 3 to 4 rounds at us, striking me in the vest approximately twice.
Okay, thank you. Were any civilians injured in this incident?
Yes, they were.
How many civilians were injured, sir?
One civilian.
Okay. And do you remember that civilian's name that was injured?
Yes, I do. Tannenor.
Okay, so that's where the attempted murder of a civilian charge comes into play.
Okay.
You also list hostage taking, two counts of that. So can you explain who was taken hostage?
Yes, I can. So when we arrived on scene, I observed Mr. Pickle pointing a gun at Tanner Nor and Sherry Nor as they were on their knees. They were on their knees at the just opposite the counter. He was pointing his gun at them. When he saw law enforcement arrive, he then fled behind the cabinet, where he then opened fire on police shortly after.
Okay. And so you interviewed both of those witnesses, I'm assuming?
I only interviewed Sherry Noor. I wasn't able to get in contact with Tanner Noor.
Okay, he was transported to the hospital then?
Yes, he was.
Okay, thank you, sir. And you mentioned that you had two other officers on scene. I do have in your report here, it shows supporting officers was Officer Cody Shaw with the LSPD and Sergeant James Tucker with the LSPD. Were you the first unit on scene?
Yes, I was.
Okay. And your body cam is the body cam that we've submitted into evidence?
Correct.
All right, thank you. Your Honor, we'd like to mark that as Exhibit A. It's going to be the body cam footage from Deputy Russell Johnson.
Yes, sir, I have that.
And to follow up with Deputy Johnson's testimony, he had also provided a sworn affidavit just in case. For one reason or another, he was not able to make it to court today. Mr. Sharkskin, have you had an opportunity to review his affidavit, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay, are you fine with entering that into evidence as well?
I'm fine with that as well, sir.
Your Honor, we'd request that you enter that in as evidence exhibit B.
Okay.
So, sworn written affidavit by Deputy Russell Johnson. And then... Deputy Johnson, you also recorded the interview with Ms. Noor. Is that correct?
Correct. Yes, I did.
Okay. Mr. Sharkskin, would you have any problem with us placing that into evidence as well?
No, sir. No objection at all.
Okay. Your Honor, we'd ask that the Sherry Noor interview recording be included in the evidence as State's Exhibit C.
That's one piece of evidence that did not cross my desk.
Okay, we'll refrain from adding that into evidence at this time, Your Honor. We'll do a supplemental at some point. We also do have physical evidence, Your Honor. I'll list those just for the record.
Okay.
Fingerprints were recovered. Deputy Johnson, did you take those fingerprints or did someone else?
I took those fingerprints.
Okay, and the fingerprints you took were from the defendant that's sitting here today?
Yes, that's correct. So I took those fingerprints, and I also compared them to the fingerprints that were then located on the hunting knife and the firearm, the Walther P99.
And so the fingerprints from the defendant were found on the hunting knife as well as on the Walther P99 pistol?
Yes, that is correct.
Okay, thank you. Your Honor, this evidence... was placed in drawer number 9 at the Mission Road Police Department just for evidentiary record-keeping purposes. Your Honor, the fingerprint identification is Y as in Young, C as in Charlie, 521, J as in John, 56, A as in Adam, Z as in Zebra, J as in John, 9465. Okay. That's the fingerprint identification card that was logged in. The hunting knife serial number is 74, K as in King, F as in Frank, L as in Lincoln, 0, G as in George, U as in Union, 388, T as in Tom, P as in Paul, J as in James, M as in Mary. The serial number for the Walther P99 pistol that was recovered and processed is 01, A as in Adam, B as in Boy, L as in Lincoln, 0, Z as in Zebra, J as in John, 890, U as in Union, D as in David, I as in Ida, V as in Victor.
That's a lot of letters, okay?
Yes, it is. the state requires some really long serial numbers, Your Honor.
Oh, definitely, okay.
So I would ask that those three items from physical evidence stored at the Mission Road PD, drawer number 9, be accepted as evidence in this case as well.
We will accept it.
Deputy Johnson, before I turn your questioning over to Mr. Sharkskin, if he has any questions, do you have anything else that you feel like you need to add?
I would just like to add and emphasize that this was a very significant event. It was very serious and, in my opinion, was calculated to an extent, as he did have body armor and two weapons on him when he entered the pawn shop. And I personally feel that if he didn't have those weapons on him, it would have been a very different situation and we would not be sitting here today with such serious charges. And I would like to emphasize that I believe Mr. Pickle poses a significant risk to the community, especially if he is not properly treated for his mental illnesses.
Okay. Did you provide the defendant with his Miranda rights, sir?
Yes, I did.
Did you attempt to question him after that
Miranda
one?
He refused questions.
He did refuse questions. Okay. That's all I have for this witness, Your Honor.
All right. Mr. Sharkskin?
Your Honor, I'm not going to refute his testimony of this witness.
Okay.
I have no further questions for this witness, Your Honor. He can be excused.
All right, Debbie, you are excused. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Is Officer Cody Shaw in the courtroom?
Yes, I am.
Would you mind stepping up, sir? Thank you, sir. Could you state your name, rank, and unit number for the record, please, sir?
Officer First Class Cody Shaw, badge number 109.
Okay, thank you.
LSPD Police Department.
Thank you, sir. So you were one of the supporting officers listed on Deputy Johnson's incident report involving Max Pickle.
Correct.
Do you recognize the subject from that incident, Max Pickle, in the courtroom today?
Yes, I do.
Could you point him out for the court, please?
He's sitting behind the desk right in front of me wearing a black suit.
Thank you, sir. Your Honor, let the record reflect that Officer First Class Shaw has pointed out the defendant, Max Pickle.
The record shall reflect.
So Officer Shaw, when you got on scene, were you shot at by the defendant?
I was not. During time of the shooting, I was behind the building trying to gain access to the rear of the establishment.
Okay. So the that would mean that the attempted murder of a police officer is for Deputy Russell Johnson and for Sergeant James Tucker, correct?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Did you handle any of the evidence, sir, that was collected that day? Or was that all handled by Deputy Johnson?
That was all processed by Deputy Johnson.
Okay. If it should be needed at a later time, sir, did you have any body cam footage of that incident?
I believe I do not.
Okay.
Due to me being at the rear of the establishment.
Okay. All right. And so, just to clarify on the record, you were not injured in any way in this situation, correct?
Correct.
Okay. Did you witness the Miranda rights being read to the defendant, sir?
I did.
And they met with department policy?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. Were you present for any attempted questioning of the defendant?
I was not. I was getting statements from Miss Sherry Knorr as well as Mr. Tanner Knorr.
Okay. That's all I have for this witness, Your Honor.
Defense, you have any questions?
No, so again, I will not repeat the testimony of this particular witness. So.
Prosecution?
I have no further questions for this witness, Your Honor. He can be excused.
All right, thank you, officer. You're excused.
Thank you.
Your Honor, the state would like to call Tanner Knorr to the stand. Thank you, Mr. Knorr. Could you state your full name for the record, please?
Tanner Knorr, sir.
Thank you, sir. With you not being a sworn law enforcement officer, sir, I do have to swear you in at this time. If you could raise your right hand and answer in the affirmative, if you swear to this, do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do, sir.
Thank you. This incident that occurred with you, and am I correct in understanding that that was your sister that was with you?
That is correct.
This incident that occurred at the pawn shop, sir, can you just give me a quick synopsis of what occurred prior to the officers arriving on scene?
Well, I took my sister to the pawn shop. I wanted to get her something nice. We were looking around, and Mr. Pickle, he walked in. I don't know if he said hi or whatever, but he was looking around, and me and my sister were talking, and she stepped away from me, and he approached her and asked her for, I think it was $20, and she said she doesn't have any. I said, I don't have it. There was some back and forth, and her started getting a little heated. He said something to my sister. I don't remember what it was, but I stepped in between the two of them and raised my hands. I said, hey, you need to back off. We don't have any money. We only carry cards. Leave us alone. He started freaking out, and he pulled his gun.
were you armed at the time, sir?
I usually carry something on me. Don't know if I was carrying that day, though.
But you didn't have a weapon visible, or you didn't...
No, I conceal carry. I do have a permit.
You didn't fire any shots in this incident?
Excuse me, Mr. Prosecutor.
Yes, sir.
Could I ask your witness to please speak up? He's barely audible here at the table.
Oh, yes, sir. You may have to shout a little bit there, Mr. Knorr.
Sorry about that. Is that better?
Yes, sir. Does that work for you, Mr. Sharkskin?
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Thank you. Okay, so he pulled his weapon. Did he shoot you, sir?
He did. I believe it was my right shoulder.
Okay, were you treated by the fire medical services?
I was treated on scene, and then they took me to the hospital.
Okay, what hospital were you taken to, sir?
Pillbox, I believe, the main one.
Okay. All right, and I'm glad to see that you're doing well, sir. It looks like their treatment did wonders.
It did indeed.
Do you have any residual issues from your gunshot wound? Is your arm all working correctly as it should, sir?
Mostly my shots are a little off at the firing range, but I'm hoping that'll get back to normal soon.
I got you. Okay, are you still undergoing any physical therapy for your injury?
Not as much as I was. It is healing pretty good, but still once every week I go see my PT.
I got you. Okay. I do need to clarify one other thing, sir, on a couple of these charges against the defendants. You we heard testimony earlier that that you and your sister were on your knees in the pawn shop when officers arrived. Were you not allowed by Mr. Pickle to leave?
No, the pawn shop? After he shot me, because he missed the first time, but after he shot me and he saw that the police were arriving, he screamed at us to get on our knees, and he ran behind the counter. We were not allowed to leave.
Okay, so you felt like at that time you were being held hostage?
Yes, we were.
Okay. That's all I have for this witness, Your Honor.
All right, Mr. Shortskin, would you like to cross-examine?
Yes, sir. Yes, I sure would.
All right.
All right. Mr. Noah, let me ask you a question just for the simplicity of court. Did you at any time ask Mr. Pickle to shoot you in the shoulder?
No, I did not.
Okay, I just want to get that out of the way. Now, let me ask you another question. You say that you was kidnapped, held against your will. Did he tell you to get down on your knees, or did y'all just do it because it looked like you wanted to stay out of the way of the bullets?
No, he yelled at us, get on our knees. Don't move.
Now, when he did that, did he have his gun aimed at you?
He did, me and my sister.
Now, did he tell you at any time that you couldn't get up and leave? You know, did he say, don't stand up on your own 2 feet and leave here at any time? In those exact words?
When he told us to get on our knees, he said, don't move or I will shoot you.
All right.
More yelled it, but...
That's all the questions I had.
I have no redirect, no further questions for this witness, Your Honor. He can be excused.
All right, Ms. Nora, you may be excused.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Your Honor, the state would like to call Ms. Sherry Nora to the stand.
All right.
Good evening, ma'am. Thank you so much. Could you state your full name for the record, please?
It's Sherry Noor.
Okay. And just so we can make sure that everybody in the back can hear you, you may have to use more of a shouting level of your voice.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yes, ma'am. With you not being a sworn law enforcement officer, Ms. Noor, I am going to have to swear you in before you testify. If you could raise your right hand, please, and answer in the affirm if you agree. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Yes, I do.
Thank you so much. In this incident in the pawn shop where you and your brother were allegedly held hostage and your brother was shot, do you still remember that event, ma'am?
Like it crystal clear, like it was yesterday.
Were you in fear for your life and your brother's life during that incident?
Yes, I was, sir.
The perpetrator of that incident, ma'am, do you recognize them as being in the courtroom today?
Yes, he's sitting at that desk next to his lawyer, L. Sharkskin.
Your Honor, let the record reflect that the witness has identified the defendant, Max Pickle.
The record so reflects.
During this... exchange of gunfire or this gunfire from the defendant and that incident, your brother had testified that y'all were told to get on your knees. Did you feel like you could leave if you so chose?
Absolutely not.
And you were in fear for your life the entire time?
Yes, sir, I was.
Were you injured in any way?
No, I was not.
Did you visit your brother in the hospital after this incident?
Yes, I did.
How did that affect you mentally to see your brother in a situation like that?
To put it nicely, it scared the bejesus out of me.
All right. Have you had any other interaction with the defendant since that?
No.
Okay. That's all the questions I have for this witness, Your Honor. Mr. Sharkskin.
Thank you, Mr. Prosecutor. I have the same questions that I'm gonna ask your brother. At any time during that holdup, did he tell you that you couldn't leave? In those words, did he say you can't get up on your feet and walk out this door right now? Maybe y'all stayed because it was exciting. Maybe y'all stayed because you hadn't been in a robbery before and you all hang around just see what happened.
No, he had us at gunpoint and was not allowing us to get up or move.
Now, let me ask you a question. You say your brother was shot, which is sad. Y'all, and I want to show the court real sad about that shooting that happened out there. When he shot your brother, did he aim the gun at your brother or was he pulled out of his holster? Did he mean to shoot him? In your eyes, was he pointed right at him like, I'm going to get you, sucker? How'd that happen in your words?
He was pointing the gun right at him. It wasn't a holster. It was an actual aim.
I'm done with this, put it in your mind.
Thank you. Mr. Prosecutor?
I have no further questions for this witness, Your Honor. She can be excused.
Ms. Noor, you're excused. Thank you, ma'am.
Now, Your Honor, at this time, with the entering of the physical evidence from the Mission Road PD that was collected, the affidavit from Deputy Johnson, the body-worn camera footage from Deputy Johnson, the in-court testimony from Deputy Johnson, and the in-court testimony from Officer First Class Cody Shaw, the state would rest with that as our evidence, Your Honor.
All right, thank you, sir. Mr. Sharkskin.
Your Honor, I will also rest. I do not have any new evidence for the court at this time.
All right, no new evidence for the court this time. All right. I do find this a very disturbing occurrence due to the potential loss of life, massive injuries that could have happened. I do believe prosecution and defense has a potential plea deal worked out. And if you will, remind me for the record again what the plea deal is potentially going to be.
Your Honor, we didn't talk specifics as far as time frames. It was more or less not knowing how much intensive inpatient treatment the defendant was going to need in a psychiatric institute. We were kind of leaving that open.
Okay, court system possibly?
As we get information, I guess if we had to put a time frame on it, I guess an indefinite amount would probably be the way to go, pending feedback from his attending physician.
Okay.
On what their suggestions were at that time, and when the physician felt like his medication had been worked out and regulated, and that his bipolar disorder was successfully treated, you know, mitigating his danger to society and himself at that point, then we could bring this back into court for review and maybe have his doctor testify at that time as to his mental state, and then let Your Honor decide if he wanted to continue mental health treatment inpatient, or if he wanted to at that time impose some form of a remainder in Bolingbroke, or if it was going to be considered time served based on his behavior and the outcome of his inpatient treatment.
All right.
So I guess just to sum it up, Your Honor, I would, Mr. Sharkskin, is that your understanding, sir, an indefinite amount of time until his doctor feels that he's ready to be released from?
Yes, sir. Treatment? We have no qualms about that. My most important thing is to get his mind clear, to get him back on the path to success. And maybe once we've got a clearance from Dr. Patel, maybe we come back to court and he can speak, Mr. Pickle can speak in his own words about what happened, to the despair and heartbreak and horror that happened that day But right now, he's not mentally fit in his own capacity to explain exactly what happened.
All right.
So I'd be asking, maybe after all that medical evaluation, we brought back to court for a hearing.
Right. Maybe, do we want to do maybe a...
I'm thinking maybe an adjudication withheld.
And maybe a court-ordered inpatient commitment to a psychiatric institute.
My understanding is up in the Vinewood Hills Parsons Rehab Center up there at Postal 844 is a pretty good place where he could do a residence at while he's seeking treatment with Dr. Patel.
That would be agreeable to the state, Your Honor. Are you good with that, Mr. Sharkskin?
Oh, yeah. I do have one question. My client is indigent, so I'd ask that all fees be waived for his attendance at that hospital. He has no funds to pay for that, and it's in excess of $10,000 a month. My client simply can't afford that, so I'm asking the court to declare him indigent and provide services for him.
I see no issues with the state providing those funds to pay for his medical bills and his stay at Parsons Rehab Center.
Does he not have a job, Mr. Sharkskin?
Oh, he's not really mentally able to hold down anything. Okay. He may take a remedial job here and there, but that's mostly from friends he knows just to keep him off the street, you know, just to provide him with a place to live. So he really does get cash in hand. Services are paid for.
Okay. Your Honor, Parsons Rehabilitation does have a program for indigent people that mm-hmm. is also funded by some private foundations as well. But in return for those private foundations assisting with some of those fees, they do require that the individual do some physical labor there at Parsons Rehab, such as helping with groundskeeping, nothing major, just, you know, helping cut the grass, you know, water the flowers, mop some floors, clean some toilets, those kind of things. Mr. Sharkskin, would your client be okay assisting with some of that stuff around the rehab center?
What I would suggest is that during the initial period, he is going to require heavy treatment, and I would recommend not letting him mingle with too many people until he's on the medication and his doctor says he thinks that he can interact, because he is, okay. Let's be honest, he unstable, you know what I mean? And I mm-hmm. think he needs to get right on the medicine and in his mind before he can take on any task.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
That makes sense. We can still, Your Honor, we can apply to some of these private foundations and see if they can assist with offsetting some of that for him. And then that would also lower the amount that the taxpayers are having to cover.
Okay. All right.
When would you want to do a first review on this, Your Honor? Would you want to push it like a year out?
I was thinking a year out to do a first review to see how far along Mr. Pickle has come, see if he's making any kind of proof that he's still enrolled in the program, he's still taking his medication, hopefully like he should, that his medication is working, that Dr. Patel will be prescribing to him, and his interaction with hospital staff and the Parsons staff is on the up and up.
Okay. Just for your record keeping, Your Honor, the potential sentence for this is 242 months, which is just over 20 years.
Right.
So I think a 1 year review is probably fair. Hearing Mr. Sharkskin talk about how intensive this treatment needs to be, I don't think hauling Mr. Pickle back in here in 3 to 6 months is going to be beneficial for him.
Anybody, even this court system, we don't want me wasting the court's time. I don't want to waste his time.
Right. And I would say maybe, Mr. Sharkskin, as we get closer to that 1 year, if you think your client needs more time prior to having a review, then we could just continue it out a little further if you want to.
Yes, sir. I did have a couple requests from the court.
Yes, sir.
Place is very strict on confidentiality. I'm
right.
going to ask that I be able to see his records, to see his progress, and to visit him on the premises to make sure he's being taken care of and provide the court with what I'm seeing with my client.
Oh, of course. I will write that into the attorney-client privilege information for
Thank
the Parsons Clinic. That would have to go without saying because we have to have someone who's going to be his advocate there, and I trust you to be his advocate.
I appreciate that, Your Grace.
Yes, sir. Any more questions there, Mr. Shortskin?
Oh, no, Your Honor. The defense completely rests on this case.
Okay. Mr. Prosecutor?
No, sir. It sounds good to me. So just to make sure that my records are correct here, he's going to be court-ordered to be held at Parsons Rehab for intensive psychological treatment.
Correct.
With Mr. Sharkskin being remaining his attorney and his personal advocate. Possible review on his status, including reports from his doctor in about a 1-year time frame.
Yes, sir.
And then you had mentioned revoking his firearm rights indefinitely.
Correct, indefinitely. You know, they could potentially be restored. It's not looking hopeful because of the acts that took place against the civilians and the peace officers in the area at the time.
But the firearm rights would definitely be revoked.
Yes.
All the way through his treatment at Parsons and then whatever review we have. And then maybe you could touch on that again at his review hearing on if you're going to extend that.
Yes. I do want to drop one charge off of his criminal record, though, the criminal possession of weapon class A, because there is no requirement in the state to have a license to open carry, and there was no grounds, no evidence submitted to show that he was concealed carrying his firearm at the time. I will remove the criminal possession weapon class A, which is a 10-month, $500 fine from the charges. The other charges at this time will stay.
I have no problem with that, Your Honor.
Okay. We're going to be adjudication withheld, pending his completion of mental health at the 1-year another 1-year review, and then from there we will review all the charges and potentially go from there, or if he needs more time in the mental health facility.
All right. Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Thank you, sir. All right. This case is temporarily closed this time. Do we have any more cases pending?
That's all we have for this docket, Your Honor. Mr. Sharkskin, are you going to ensure that Mr. Pickle is delivered to Parsons, or do you want him taken by law enforcement out there, sir?
Well, I was going to see if the judge could put in an order for Mr. Patel to come and retrieve my client at a date of your choosing. I feel every second he needs to be with somebody who understands what he's going through. You know, he's sitting here right now looking all calm, but inside he's just a bunch of bones all jittery, ready to jump out of them clothes he's wearing. And I would prefer him to be treated with respect and not by somebody who may not understand what he's going through in his head right now.
Okay. Does he have his own residence, Mr. Sharkskin?
Right now, he's staying with a relative of his auntie.
Okay. Does he have any affairs he needs to get in order before he's committed?
I don't know. Are you dating anybody, man, son?
No, I'm not talking about dating. I'm talking about, does he have any pets he needs to find somebody to look out for? Does he have any bills he needs to make sure somebody's going to pay for him? You know, things he needs to...
Get somebody else
on to take care of him while he's
in
there.
They got a couple his grand grandma, they kind of help give his aunt money to take care of him. Yeah, so he doesn't have any personal bills out of his pocket.
Your Honor, with him not having anything to take care of or finish up prior to being committed and due to the seriousness of this, I would ask that we try to get Dr. Patel to get him picked up and transported out there within the next 24 hours.
Absolutely. Mr. Sharkskin, where will your client be within the next 24 hours that you can guarantee me that he can be picked up by Dr. Patel?
Well, Your Honor, I would recommend that he not be freed from your hold. He needs to stay in custody for his own safety and for the safety of the city.
Okay.
So there are some holding cells down there, Your Honor. Do we want to take him down there temporarily until Dr. Patel can pick him up?
Yes, I believe we do need to have him remanded to our custody in the court system, and Dr. Patel could come to this location and pick him up.
All right, Deputy Johnson.
Yes, sir. You might take him into custody.
I don't see any need to handcuff him up or anything like that, Mr. Sharkskin. Do you?
I appreciate that.
He looks like he's coming out, unless he starts.
This officer here is going to take you downstairs, get you some lunch, and get you some comfy clothes, okay? Okay. I want to tell you what a beautiful story I was told here today about you, and I wish you all the success, and I'll talk to you soon, okay?
Okay.
All right, Mr. Pickle, follow me this way, sir.
What a beautiful story. What a beautiful man.
Best of luck, Mr. Pickle.
Thank you.
I'm trying to hold all my tears in my head right now.
I bet you are, Mr. Theatrics. Mr. Sharkskin.
Yes, sir.
Your Honor, I don't have any other cases pending today. Did you have anything else for us?
No, sir. I believe that is all. I do appreciate everybody coming in and respecting the sanctity of our court.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Court is dismissed. You be safe out there.
Thank you.